Thank you, Parizad. Parizad is a dear friend, so don't believe half of what she said. Friend, first of all, just so happy and so proud being here. Anil, you and Vivek, when 50 years down the line, when people will think of Mumbai and Mumbai's fitness, believe me, your names will be up there. You've changed the fitness culture of this city, and big round of applause for Anil and Vivek. Friends, at CARE Foundation, as I said, our core philosophy is that anybody can jump, and it comes from one belief that everyone is special, and given a chance, I think, as Mr. Sankaraman said, given a chance, anybody can excel. Whatever little we can do to, you know, give that small little push is worth whatever effort you put in life. We do three aspects as far as anybody can jump is concerned. There are three compartments in which we work. One, obviously, carrying forward whatever wonderful work my wife was doing, and that is basically core philanthropic work on ground. Second, we've started an incubator for young charities. So today there is a lot of talk of the number of startups coming in the country. We want to be the next incubator for charity startups in the country. And we have some wonderful minds across the country wanting to do great work. And anybody can jump will be an incubator for great ideas in the charitable field. Third, which is sort of a personal passion in life, and that is fitness, how at all levels we can promote fitness. And one philosophy there is right to play. Sir, every child in this country should have access to a playground. That's the dream that anybody can jump. Kshatriya Saab is here. Sir, we should come up with a policy of creating playgrounds. Today, there are wonderful playgrounds in the city of Mumbai and in the state of Maharashtra. But if a child goes to a playground with a football, the reaction would be as if he's come there with a bomb. Every recreational ground that we have can be a perfect Nananani park and also be a perfect playground. Sir, give us 100 playgrounds across the city of Mumbai. In 7 working days, I will give you a plan which will work perfectly as a recreational ground and a playground. We need access. Our children need access to playgrounds. As I said, really, really, whatever little we can do to give our children access to playgrounds, we must. We have a wonderful opportunity. The new DPDCR is coming, and we have a wonderful opportunity of creating playgrounds for our children. We should do whatever we can. India needs to be a fitter country. John should not be the only example of fitness in this country. Yeah. Every child can be a fitness icon in this country. We just need to give them access. Thank you very much once again. Great being here.
Thank you. Thank you. thank you very much, Your Excellency, for the award. This award really truly means a lot, because this award will go for all the children, thousands of children of the farmers who have lost their lives in the Vidarbha as well as the Marathwada district, and for the education of those children. So I feel that it is very appropriate that we today realize that the Light of Life Trust today is bringing light into the lives of hundreds and thousands and millions of people all across the globe, and particularly in rural India, where today there is complete darkness. Darkness of education, darkness as far as poverty is concerned, and we've seen that we are able to break the cycle of poverty only through education and healthcare. So truly, this has been a very, very special moment for me, very inspiring, and I'd like to thank United Way, Standard Chartered, and ProCam, and everybody for making this platform possible to become a whole community of philanthropists working together towards millions of causes which have touched the lives of truly the underprivileged. And today, I really specially thank my team, which has been truly dedicated and hardworking in raising all the possible funds for the NGO. I'd also like to thank all the donors as well as the individuals who have contributed all the support and participation in the marathon this year. And finally, of course, I would like to acknowledge thank God for everything, and that He's made it possible for all of us to come together to share this wonderful award. Thank you very much. May God bless you.
Thank you, Willie. Thank you so very, very much. Thank you. So, ladies and gentlemen, we have another very, very special person. Another change icon. You know, they say great hunters hunt in pairs. It was true of lethal U-boats in World War II. It's true of modern aerial combat. And it's true of a husband and wife duo who come all the way from a small town, Ayyukudi, in Tamil Nadu, each year to participate in the Standard Chartered Mumbai Marathon, sharing a dream of building a valley for the disabled. They not only work in tandem, but have developed a really healthy competition amongst themselves, motivating and pushing each other to go the extra mile. Ladies and gentlemen, this year, this wonderful lady has raised 136% more funds for the Amar Seva Sangam than she did last year. And what's more is that this husband-wife duo together has raised a little over 1.24 crores at the Standard Chartered Mumbai Marathon 2016, which is a feat in itself. It's truly together in hand, they triumph. Put your hands together in welcoming on stage an incredible woman, Miss Ramani Sankara Raman, who has individually raised 51,04,104 for the Amar Seva Sangam.
This great recognition. I'm very happy to receive this honor with my husband. And we have 14,000 service users. And we are extending our community base to 800 villages, and still we have a long way to go. And this is a great platform to get awareness of all social problems, and not only social problems, and find solutions also. It will give enormous solutions, and it is becoming a great knowledge portal, which is gathering all NGOs and creating a great network. Thank you for this opportunity.
Thank you, Ramani. Thank you very, very much. Thank you. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for all of us to hear the Honorable Governor speak. And I'd like to request John and Anuraga and Anil to please take a seat. Could we please put our hands together for the Honorable Governor, please?
जी ये अभी 13th एडिशन था और इसमें हमने फॉर एनजीओज 28 करोड़ वी हैव रेज फॉर द एनजीओज और हिंदुस्तान में ये सिंगल लार्जेस्ट फंड रेजर स्पोर्ट्स इवेंट है. मैं कहना चाहता हूँ कि ये सिंगल लार्जेस्ट स्पोर्ट्स इवेंट है हमारे कंट्री में, द स्टैंडर्ड चार्टर्ड मुंबई मैराथन. और इसका मैं अभी 10 या 11 साल हो चुके मैं ब्रांड एम्बेसडर हूँ. आई एम फील वेरी प्राउड टू बी द फेस ऑफ दिस मैराथन और मैं बहुत खुश हूँ आज आके हिज एक्सेलेंसी द गवर्नर मुंबई भी थे, हमारे जो चीफ सेक्रेटरी ऑफ महाराष्ट्र भी थे यहाँ पे, और प्रो कैम्प के अनिल और विवेक सिंह जिन्होंने इस इवेंट को ऑर्गेनाइज किया वो भी थे यहाँ पे. आई सपोर्ट एन जी ओज, आई सपोर्ट डिफरेंट एन जी ओज, बट एज अ ब्रांड एम्बेसडर आई सपोर्ट ऑल दी एन जी ओज. सो द ब्यूटी ऑफ बींग द ब्रांड एम्बेसडर इज के हर एक एन जी ओ को हम सपोर्ट करते हैं. और जैसे मैंने कहा कि इस साल हमने 28 करोड़ जमा किए एंड आई थिंक इट्स फैंटास्टिक. सो नेक्स्ट ईयर आई थिंक हम लोग 30-30 करोड़ भी क्रॉस कर सकते हैं, शायद 32 करोड़ भी क्रॉस कर सकते हैं. और इसमें से ज़्यादातर आपको ये दिखाई देगा आज के प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस में कि हमारे जितने यंगस्टर्स हैं, यंग लीडर्स जिसे हम बोलते हैं, 101 यंग लीडर्स थे और उन यंग लीडर्स ने काफ़ी पैसे जमा किए. एंड द यंगेस्ट जो फंड रेजर है वो 5 साल का और एक 9 साल का, दो भाई है 5 and 9 years old और इन्होंने काफ़ी फंड्स जमा किए 2 लाख के ऊपर. इस साल भी इस स्टैंडर्ड चार्टर्ड मुंबई मैराथन हम यही कोशिश करेंगे कि जो फुल मैराथन है 42 किलोमीटर्स उसमें और लोग भागे हिस्सा लें. एंड really looking forward to that actually.
John, thank you very much. Thank you. Masha ki shaadi ho rahi hai kya kya John
arun pakad yaar ha ek minute
bhai ruk jao. And really made the Standard Chartered Mumbai Marathon the movement that it is. Come on guys, a picture. Thank you very, very much. Thank you to all the guests. Ladies and gentlemen, our governor has to leave. Can we please give him a huge round of applause and a standing ovation for being here with us today? Thank you, sir. Thank you very, very much.
ये तो बहुत बहुत स्पेशल इवेंट है, क्योंकि मैं तो हर साल मैराथन में दौड़ती हूँ और हर साल मैं बिल्कुल हैरान रहती हूँ, क्योंकि इतना सा पैसा जमा करना बहुत बहुत मुश्किल चीज़ है और सब इतने इतने अच्छे कॉजेज के लिए। मैं तो हर साल दौड़ती हूँ, बट मुझे तो पता है कि फ़ंड रेजिंग एक बहुत डिफ़िकल्ट चीज़ है। इट्स डिफ़िकल्ट टू आस्क पीपल फॉर मनी, एंड जो भी ये कमरा में जो भी लोग हैं वो सब मतलब बिल्कुल सेल्फलेसली फ़ंड रेजिंग कर रहे हैं और इतने अच्छे कॉजेज के लिए। सो इट्स अ फैंटास्टिक इवनिंग एंड इट्स ग्रेट टू ऑनर दीज पीपल बिकॉज इट्स अ रियली टफ जॉब। ये देख के तो आई एम वेरी इंस्पायर्ड और मैं तो जैसे मैं कह रही थी मैं दौड़ती तो हूँ, बट फंड रेजिंग इज़ अ डिफरेंट लीग ऑफ डिफिकल्टी। सो इट्स रियली अमेजिंग और इतने सारे लोग को मदद करना, दिस इट्स अ रियली स्पेशल थिंग एंड आई थिंक वी शुड हैव मोर सच इवेंट्स टू इनकरेज पीपल टू हेल्प अदर्स।
To earn the basic necessity of life, number of degree people, nowadays people have more degree but a lesser employment. Can you say why it is?
So I think, I mean, there are of course lots of macro problems and lots of things that need changing, and I think, you know, as they say, many drops make the sea. So I think everybody can contribute by doing something in their own capacity. Everyone has a different level that they can help with. I have a TV show, The Tara Sharma Show, with season 4 is starting, and we're doing it as a platform to discuss topical issues with a view to helping bring about change. But everyone's way of giving and bringing about change is different. So I think people who can fundraise and raise money, people who can go out and teach people, people who even in their own way can teach the right values to their own kids, I think all those ways of contributing to help make society better and to help people who are less privileged.
So are you planning to start any of your NGOs to change the world, to change the perception?
You know, I have a show and I try through the show to raise awareness on different topics, and that I think, as I said, I think people can help in whatever way they can. Some people can do it by raising money, some people can do it by going out and teaching in schools, some people can do it through the media, so I think some people are policy makers. So I think if everyone in their own way, even if it's something as small as, you know, helping the person who's on the street outside your door, or somebody who works for you, or somebody who, you know, so I think it's nothing is too small, as they said in there. Like, of course, it's amazing when the help is so huge, but I think everyone in their small way, if they can do something, you know, many small drops make an ocean. So I think you can bring about change. Thank you.
Thank you.